Now, the Tulsa Massacre is horrific. It was the largest massacre of black people in this country, the largest racial massacre in this country. But it is not an extreme, isolated example of the oppression that this system has inflicted on black people. It's not an isolated case. Instead, it's part of a long, unending chain of savagery this country has inflicted on the African American people. And let's walk through that. If you say, Carl, why are you hyping it up? I ain't hyping nothing up. If anything, I'm understating it. And let's talk about this reality. And then you tell me that I'm overstating it, that I'm talking about stuff that didn't really happen. Look at World War I when this happened. There were, after World War I when this happened, there were waves of attacks like this. In 1919, over three dozen areas across the country, there were mob attacks on black people by white mobs, ranging from major cities like Chicago, even down to rural areas in Arkansas. Black people were murdered. Black people had their property taken, destroyed. People were put in concentration camps. What was the reason for this? It was things like black sharecroppers in a place in Arkansas hired a white lawyer to represent them in their negotiations with the land, the plantation owners, because they knew they were getting robbed. And they think, we get a white lawyer up in here, maybe we'll actually get what we are owed for the cotton that we're producing. That was deemed an act of insurrection. That's how they were looking at this stuff. Now, after 1919, the shit was so widespread and so foul that the leaders of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People dubbed that period the Red Summer of 1919. Many of these attacks were also met with armed black resistance, like in Tulsa, much of it spearheaded by black veterans who had fought in World War I, men who'd been sent to Europe to fight to defend democracy, came back and realized, we ain't got none. We can fight for democracy over here. Maybe we need to fight for some rights on this side of the water. But it didn't just start there. We can step back. Before these attacks, there were centuries of black people being held in slave chains, forced through whipping and other forms of torture to work from can't see in the morning till can't see at night, building up the wealth and power of the growing American empire. That's part of that long, unending chain of oppression. It runs through massacres that were perpetrated after slavery, after the Civil War, when slavery was officially abolished. But white mobs again were unleashed to attack newly freed black people to keep them suppressed, to keep them from exercising their rights. It was, this chain runs through thousands of lynchings, decades of Ku Klux Klan terror and Jim Crow laws that suppressed black people and kept white supremacy in effect. Black people and those who stood with them have met these attacks with fierce resistance. We could start with the slave rebellions, the Underground Railroad. We could look at the 175,000 black soldiers who joined the Union Army during the Civil War, who fought to end slavery. We could take it up through the resistance that continued against the Jim Crow laws, against the lynch mob terror, Jim Crow segregation. This history of attacks and fierce resistance is not just a historical thing. It continues right down to today. Look around you, police murder, mass incarceration that disproportionately targets black and brown people, huge disparities in income, in wealth, in education, in housing, and a number of other fronts between blacks and whites. All this continues despite decades of resistance, ranging from the uprisings in the 1960s down to the millions of people who poured into the streets last year calling for justice for George Floyd and an end to white supremacy. But with all this resistance, even as all this goes down, the attacks continue. They don't let up a bit. Out of all this, we can identify an ugly truth and draw an important lesson. The ugly truth is, to quote from this pamphlet, Bob Avakian for the Liberation of Black People and for the Emancipation of All Humanity. Here's what it says. For the powers that be in this country, the humanity of black people has never counted for anything. They have never been valued as human beings, but only as things to be exploited, oppressed, and repressed. And the important lesson that we must draw is that the oppression of black people and the white supremacy that drives it are built into the fabric of the capitalist imperialist system we live under. There's a historically evolved toxic combination between white supremacy and the capitalist imperialist system. This system cannot and will not end this racial oppression. This oppression must be ended, and it can be ended, but not under this system. Ending this oppression and uprooting white supremacy can only be done through a real revolution to abolish this system.